I'd like to call on the children ministry for a play. The children ministry. The children ministry, please. Why they come? The children ministry to come here, please.
Good evening, everyone. The church ministry is going to be demonstrating the Good Samaritan. You guys know today is the day to celebrate love. So stay tuned. Safe road. He was caught by some mean robbers who beat him up, robbed him, and left him to die. The poor man was lying there, and he heard someone approach. The first person to see him was a priest, someone who worked for the church. Do you think the priest should have stopped to help the man? Wouldn't that show his faith was real? Well, he didn't stop. He kept right on going. So another guy walked by. This was a Levite. Someone else important in the temple. And guess what? He didn't stop either. He kept riding right on going. Well, a third man came along, and by this time, maybe the poor man was ready to give up. The man who came was a Samaritan. Now, Samaritan and Jesus' time were not well liked. They were considered sort of bad guys who didn't follow the rules of the Jewish law and were not respected at all. This Samaritan was walking along, and the man on the roadside must have thought he was done for. But the Samaritan man stopped. Not only did he stop, he helped the man. But he put bandages on his wound, but put the man on his donkey and took him to an inn. Then he gave the innkeeper money and told him to take care of whatever he needed. So Jesus told him to emphasize to the people that love is not just about what we say, but what we do. Sometimes we get caught up in following the law or looking good or saying all of the right thing. But if we are not demonstrating love, that's all pretty silly. God wants us to love people by caring for them. We pray for them, we do things for them, and we treat them with kindness, as Jesus would do. When we can do that, we show the love of God and fulfill his greatness commandment.
Thank you. demonstrate love. God is love. And he said we should love our neighbors as ourselves. Hallelujah. The end.
Amen. Put your hands together for the children ministry. Amen. I thought the beginning was fighting. I thought they were really fighting. Seriously. You know, back in Liberia, we have a transportation system when three people can sit at the back and one person sit with the aisle in the front. So for years that's been going on. It used to be four, but they called it down when Ebola came to Liberia, they called it down to three. Speaking of Ebola, before I go there, let me say this thing to you. I was in the service last week, Sunday, in Minnesota, so one guy. So, while in the service in Minnesota, he called this guy to give testimony, right? He was like, praise God, the church said, amen. He said, thank God that coronavirus didn't kill me in China. The thing makes sense, I came from China, I had coughing. So he brought you, then he went past the back to the pastor said, no, give it to the usher. The usher said, no, give it to the deacon said, no, I don't want it. The whole people make up our mind. The whole service was empty. Everybody ran away. Coronavirus, I ain't got to ever. So speaking of the Texas, right? A lady was at the back, and I was in the front. So two other girls joined us in the car. You know, like Liberian, we got a way of, you know, gossiping if we want to gossip for you. Sometimes we feel that you're not educated. We start to spell whatsoever that we want to gossip about. So the girl in the car, she like, ba. Like, in Liberia, we say ba, it mean my friend. Like, ba. This O-L-D-M-A, which is old mom, or old man, is very U-G-L-Y. She saying the woman is ugly. So the lady didn't talk at all. When we drove like 1 mile, she decided to stop too. The lady got down from the car. She did her glasses just like, she said, just like your M-O-T-H-E-R. Don't curse any old man. Seriously, that's very disrespectful.